6 6 6.
Hello? Anybody here? Bruh, this place is so cool. So we're right in front of the Netherland Plaza, also known as the Carew Tower. It was constructed in 1931. Same group of builders that built this, well, actually it was one gentleman, goes by the name of William Arlager. Don't quote me on that exact name, I may have said it wrong, but he was responsible not only for this building, but the Empire State Building, Penn Station, the DC Union Station, Lincoln Memorial. I mean, this guy was well known. Now, this happens to be one of the most haunted places in the Queen City, Cincinnati, Ohio. Let's do this.
Yo, what happened to the American flag there? Look at the American flag. It's like all knotted up and stuff.
So you may be wondering, why on earth are these Floridians, first of all, here in Ohio in the middle of the winter time, but we're wearing short sleeve shirts. That's right. It is freezing out there. But here's the thing. We didn't want to be walking around with like a heavy jacket and coat because it is warm inside. Now, what the heck is that noise? Does it make noise like that? This place originally was designed with this new concept called a city within a city. The gentleman that originally built this, he was denied financing, which was really sad. It's kind of a blessing and a curse. Check out what happened. Being that he was denied this financing, he went ahead and sold all his stocks. I guess he had a lot of money in his stocks. Well, when he sold his stocks, he used that to build this project. Guess what happened after that happened?
The tremendous crowds which you see gathered outside the stock exchange are due to the greatest crash in the history of the New York Stock Exchange and market prices.
It was good that they denied him financing because the stock market crashed. I'm pretty sure this is what started and fueled the Great Depression. Oh, cool, look. I didn't even have to do any research. All you gotta do is come over here and read some of this. By the way, I did not read any of this to give you any of that information. I actually did my own research, but yeah. It started out, the idea, in 1929, and it was built in a short amount of time, actually. I hear there was thousands of workers. I have no idea what that says. If you want to pause the video and read it, you're more than welcome. And like always, I lost James. Now, let's talk about this whole city within a city. He wanted to build something with this vision of not only a hotel, but like a shopping mall, and you can see that's what we have here. Offices, a place where people can come and not have to leave. You know, they could come and stay here. I hear James, but I heard a woman. Anyways, we'll talk a little bit more on the history later. There's a lot, and there's some cool haunted history here too. This goes to the hotel, and there is like a wedding or something going on up there, which is crazy because it's past midnight right now. I mean, wedding parties do go into, what, 3 a.m.? One of the things that I noticed right away when coming here to, it's owned by Hilton, by the way, now it is, but it was always the Netherland Plaza, or, you know, the Carew Tower. I don't see the Carew name, but it has this striking resemblance to me with the Queen Mary. Like, a lot of the woodwork, it looks really similar. Like, I've never been to a place where I had like Queen Mary vibes, but it makes sense. It was built exactly around the same time in the 1930s as the Queen Mary. Now, in the 1990s, they invested more money later on and they redid a lot of these shops. They brought in new vendors and there was an arcade. It'd be cool if that arcade was still here, but I feel like arcades are a thing of the past now.
Love arcades.
I know, me too. There's still some places that have arcades.
Yeah, Dave and Buster's.
Oh yeah, Dave and Buster's, cool one, yeah. Chuck E. Cheese.
Chuck E. Cheese.
That's right. Well, anyways, like if you look over here, You can kind of see some of that architecture. I'm going to take you inside here in a second. That's a pretty fancy stuff.
What? What happened?
Is that thing electric? I think somebody was just walking by right now and legit just gave that a good push. It's still freaking moving. Wait, this has to be electric.
Bro, I don't think they're electric. That went through, you gotta push it.
I guess I wouldn't say push. Is somebody out there?
Why would somebody do that to the door and not come in? That doesn't make any sense.
Maybe they were getting ready to come in. Oh, look, it even says here, conserve energy. Please use revolving door. Because this must be an electric door.
This is definitely not an electric door. Yeah.
That's cool, though. It's very 1930s.
Maybe the wind blew it?
What if some ghostesses were making their way inside? It's possible.
Toward us.
Okay, so one of the most compelling stories here is the story of the green lady. Or the lady in green, the green dress. James.
The lady in the green dress.
Did you poop yourself?
No.
You literally got a chat stain.
Here, that's here. Because these are... Bruh, these are the pants I wore in the devil's butthole. Let me see. That's what happens. You sit down in the tunnel for an hour when you're trapped in there because of rain.
Total Queen Mary vibes right now. I found this little hidden area. Also found a little hidden door right there. But then when I went in there, it's security.
Dude, check this out. There's like more like shops or something in here.
Cool. That says Mayflower room. Bro, it's spooky down here. Oh, this is the fitness center. It's also, well, it's Snap Fitness now, but like I said, it was originally built with a fitness center back in the day too. And it has a pool. It almost reminds me of like a dead mall.
Distribute this on a major level. Then you realize,
what the hell? Your phone just started going off? That's weird.
You know, a good song, but it's well,
I heard
noise
down there. Check.
I heard something on there too.
Why would my phone just go off like that? That is really strange. But didn't you hear like a noise down there? Right before my phone went off?
Maybe some of the wedding parties down here.
I don't hear anybody down here, bro.
Bro, there's something scary right behind you. I mean, even the railing right there, I mean, that's total Queen Mary vibe. When James and I first parked here for the first time at the Netherland, it's the Netherland, what?
Netherland Plaza.
I want to call it the Neverland Ranch. Netherland Plaza. So we park, they have a really cool parking area. We forget something because it said, you know, don't forget your ticket. Well, I go back to the car after we're already in the elevator and we pushed the button to the lobby. And we try to go back to the floor that our car was parked in, and we literally went through like 10 floors and we could not. And I mean, it was like within.
We forgot what floor we parked on.
It was like a paradox. It, I mean, and what
we
was crazy.
Every single floor, bro. Every single one.
What did all those floors have in common? They were empty.
They were empty, yeah.
They were empty. There was no cars. Mm-hmm. But when we just left our car, it was full of cars, or our parking lot, it was full of cars. And then, like, all of a sudden, I was like, well, did we look at this floor? And we did, but we went back to it and the cars appeared. I don't know if that's ever happened to anybody else. It was really weird off camera, but very interesting story. Maybe our mind was playing tricks on us. I literally thought that somebody spiked something in my drink or something. My Coca-Cola, by the way, I don't really drink. Check out this elevator. There's a lot of floors.
45 floors.
45?
It says 20, express elevator from 20 to 45.
Get out. This is probably one of the biggest hotels I've ever
stayed
in.
Hands down. Hands down.
Alright, bro. Good luck.
Good luck, man.
I'll see you in a little bit.
Alright. Let me know how that floor is. Alright,
fam. So James and I are going to do something a little bit different. We're going to go to probably the more active floors. I'm gonna start out on the third floor, which is where the woman in green, or the lady in green, has been seen. And this particular floor also is popular with the Kennedys. They love this floor. Oh, this place is so nice. So the Hall of Mirrors has a really unique story.
Is that the door?
It is really noisy. And here, oh, don't tell me it's locked. No! There's gotta be another door. Gotta be another door. Oh, here we go. It is open. Oh, cool. I didn't know this was like a banquet hall or something. The Hall of Mirrors. The story goes about the lady in green is that her husband died here as a builder. There's a couple different stories on how she died. Some say that it was a broken heart, but after she passed away. Hopefully I get your story right. She was starting to roam this area. Perhaps, and I mean what I'm thinking, is that her husband may have passed away in here. And that's how the legend goes. That's why this area is haunted. But yeah, some people have witnessed seeing this woman dressed in either a green dress, or maybe she is, you know, her appearance looks green. It's beautiful. But you can see there's mirrors over there. It's really quiet in here. I am hearing noises all around me right now. I do have my phone with me, and I was taking like a couple just random pictures. It is very dim in here, but it looks like it's a lot brighter than it is on my camera. But it sounded like one of these doors was shaking. I don't want to wander too much because I don't know if I'm really supposed to be here. I mean, that door was locked, but this one wasn't. Maybe I'll be fine. So John F. Kennedy and his wife used to love the Hall of Mirrors. I guess, yeah, it's a hall. But I didn't. Yeah, it's covered in mirrors. They say that mirrors are spirit portals. To me, these look like windows, but they are mirrors. Cool. Yeah, there's mirrors everywhere. Since the 1930s, they have been having like banquets here, weddings. Wonder how much that costs. This is a beautiful place. Beautiful. If you're watching this video and you have never been to the Queen City, Cincinnati, Ohio, even if you're just gonna have like some food at the restaurant, which by the way, was voted the best restaurant in the entire United States. That's right, here at this hotel, the Netherland Plaza. There's even a nightclub. So, you know, maybe you could have some drinks, have some food, and check this place out. Walk around and get a nice little tour. Bring your phone or a camera. Take lots of photos. Such a neat place. Not what I envisioned. Honestly, I'm blown away. I thought a hall of mirrors. I thought it was gonna be like a hallway with mirrors. I didn't think it was gonna be an actual like banquet hall. That's what this is. Hello? Anybody here? Do you want me to leave? Tap again. You just tap one time. See anybody in there? Cool. This must be the Netherland Plaza, like a portrait of it. Probably the foyer. I don't know. have not seen anything yet that looks like that, but I don't know. Let's, maybe it's over here. Let's go look.
The owners of this place have done an extraordinary job of keeping that old vintage charm, you know, from the 1930s and preserving it. I'm sure a lot of money goes into this place.
That's where I was just a second ago, and I traveled all the way around and I ended up here. Did not see this maintenance cart there. Maybe there is a maintenance worker floating around, but I don't see them. Maybe they're in here in the unoccupied julep room. What's in here? Ooh, this is cool. It's like a little mini banquet room.
There's a picture of what it looked like back in the 1930s. I find this super interesting, and you see it a lot in historical buildings, but there were like little chutes like this for mail back in the day. See, we're on the third floor, and it would go to a post office box downstairs. Pretty awesome. Let's go to the fourth floor. Now this is another really haunted floor, and it does connect to the Hall of Mirrors. The Hall of Mirrors did have a balcony. Oh, hey.
What's up, man?
Anything interesting?
Yeah.
It got like hot,
bro.
It's like really hot in here.
What?
What's the matter?
What the hell happened? You're like you seen a ghost or something.
Yeah, I was walking by a door.
Uh-huh.
Somebody opened it to come out, so I put my camera like down like this. Didn't even record it, and I look, there's nobody there, and I show it, there's nobody there.
So it's really funny, when I got on the third floor, well, right before, when I got on the elevator, you know, you went to the fourth floor and I went, right. There was a...
Forgot to mention this, there was a couple that like walked into the elevator, like I was filming and stuff, and I was gonna show you the elevator, and they walk in, I'm like, I put the camera down. But that happened to you, but there wasn't anybody there.
Dude, there was nobody there.
Like, interesting.
Yeah.
Interesting. Have you tried to...
Did you find the Hall of Mirrors?
The Hall of Mirrors is downstairs.
Okay.
It's downstairs.
Wait, on the third floor.
This is the Hall of Mirrors right here.
This is the Hall of Mirrors?
Yeah. Okay, look, it's not what you're thinking. It's not like a hallway like that. That's what I thought it was. I thought it was going to be an actual hallway.
This is it?
It's an actual, like, huge hall. Like a banquet hall.
Oh, we can't
hall.
Get in here. I already tried.
Oh, you tried to go in there?
Yeah, but I will tell you this. I did this. Uh-huh. And then I was recording, and I heard a something like that.
I heard the same thing, but
really?
Downstairs, it was something with the door. I think some of these doors are electronically locked. That may be, but there is a door open downstairs.
That could be true.
You could totally check it out.
Like, there is a reasonable explanation for things sometimes that we just don't realize.
I try to find a reasonable explanation. I mean, maybe, you know, it could be a not so reasonable explanation, but it's always, I mean, it could be
wind.
It does happen, yeah.
It does happen.
But if you go downstairs, directly beneath us, is the side doors open? And dude, it is gonna blow your mind.
Really?
It's literally probably one of the most beautiful things. You remember that hall at the Queen Mary where it had like the dance floor that we found?
And we didn't get in the first couple of times we went
there. Right, yeah. And we accidentally, like, they left the door open,
yes,
and we got
dude,
in.
It was huge.
Beautiful. That is like...
It's like that?
It's like that, but a more beautiful version of that. I mean, really? The one on the Queen Mary is beautiful, but this is like, it just takes your breath away, bro. It's nice. And there is some spooky sounds going on down there.
Really?
Spooky, spooky sounds. Yeah, I heard some taps. I heard something with the door. Maybe it was you. Maybe it was when you were up here messing with this door.
Oh,
maybe that's what I heard.
Could have been.
Okay. I mean, I'm not trying to rule it out.
Maybe that could have been. All right.
All right, bro.
What do you want to do after you just want to do the other
floor? You know what? Let's go all... There's like so many floors here.
You start picking random floors?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Good.
Maybe we'll roll together. You want to roll together?
How about we meet up at a certain time? You want to?
Oh, you know what?
Call me when you're ready to meet up.
I'm going to do a live stream of us filming, us sleeping.
Really?
Yeah.
A live stream of us?
I got a lot of people excited about it. Yeah, we're going to do that.
Wait, wait a minute. You talking to me about this first?
Well, we're talking about it now.
Yeah, the camera going to be on you then.
No, it's going to be on both of us.
While we're sleeping all night?
Yeah. I mean, bro, we got like 5 hours. It's super late right now. It's like almost 2 a.m. We'll talk more about it.
All right. Well, I hope you don't fart in your sleep like usual.
This is called Rosewood? Oh, this is spooky. I have no idea what goes on this fourth floor, but when we were talking to the receptionist, downstairs, or, you know, the person that checks you in, concierge, she said that the third and the fourth floor are the ones that people have seen the most and experienced the most. We have been to our room already. Our room is on the sixth floor. Remember I was telling you how a lot of famous people have stayed here? Well, Elvis Presley stayed in the room that we're staying the night right now. If you don't know who Elvis Presley is, you're missing out, man. Also known as the King. Carnival on real ice.
Oh, look at those photos. Dang.
I'm thinking Rosewood is another banquet hall. Could be wrong. It's hard to make out what's in there. I've been to many haunted locations. Of course, there's some that you just feel like, you feel like a negative energy. I'm not getting those vibes here, nothing negative. Like I said, I feel like I'm on the Queen Mary. Really sad situation going on right now with the Queen Mary. If anybody that's connected to the historical society with the Queen Mary wants to reach out to me, I would love to go over there, maybe do a really cool video. I mean, I'm talking about the coolest video I've ever done on the Queen Mary. There's talks out there of the Queen Mary being just, you know, left and sunk into the ocean. And it's because of the costly repairs to keep up with the Queen Mary. Supposedly, like, the pool area is falling apart and there's water getting in. And I do not want to see the Queen Mary be lost forever. That would absolutely break my heart. Conference coordinator. Wow. Yeah, I'm sure they had so many different conventions. Like I said, it was like, what was that?
Oh, maybe it was the elevator. Yeah, it's the parking garage. I'm telling you, it's like a paradox.
When it opened, the Karu Tower Garage was the world's most automated garage.
Cool.
While I was walking, you know, in that area where the Hall of Mirrors is, but the balcony top on the fourth floor, I couldn't help but feel like there was a bunch of people watching me. Maybe it's because you're watching me. No, it really felt like there was, you know, you just feel like somebody's maybe behind you or on the side of you. Like it was that feeling.
It was called the Karu. You know, I haven't been outside very much of the building. Was it always called the Netherland Plaza?
Or was that the original name? I don't know. Beautiful.
Whoa, cool.
Check it out.
Look at that. Yeah, it looks like a conference center. I'm gonna piss my pants if it does it back on the other side. Maybe number two. Probably just guest, hotel guest. things have quieted down here quite a bit. James and I started filming. It was almost like, I think 12, yeah, it was midnight. We're like, yeah, people are gonna be sleeping now. Apparently not.
What's over here?
Maybe this is a suite. That's pretty sweet. That whole live streaming thing that I was talking about, if you didn't know, I have a channel that is dedicated to just live streams now. Anytime I've done a live stream, or sometimes when I do live streams on this channel or my vlog channel, there are times where I'll delete those live streams because I've noticed that it kind of takes away from the whole like edited video experience. So I wanted to have a channel where it was just live streams. I could leave the live streams up. You could watch them whenever. Well, I kind of had this idea to do a live stream. I've done it before actually, but not with James. I'm gonna do a live stream tonight where our fams are gonna be able to help us out. Maybe there's a sound that they hear at a certain timestamp. Maybe they see something. One thing about the room that we're staying in, I'm calling it the Elvis room. It's really, really quiet. So if we hear any noises, that's gonna freak me out. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna sleep like a baby tonight because I am exhausted. I'm working right now off of maybe 4 hours of sleep. All right, so we're back on the fourth floor.
It's another one of those mail chutes. Pretty cool.
Let's go to the very top floor. A lot of floors don't have 13. Like 13 was like a bad luck number.
Alrighty.
Let's go to the 27th floor. Oh no. Okay, so just a little bit ago, I actually had to run back to the room. Hopefully this opens. Okay, the L works.
Hey, I gotta share something funny with you. So my friend James left his phone out and I grabbed it and I put, one time I got freaky with a sandwich. Well, it was meant to say sandwich, but I spelled it snadwich because I was trying to do it real fast.
A little bit later, I left my phone alone and James grabbed it and wrote this.
Do you ever pick a wedgie, then smell your fingers after to make sure they are still fresh? I tend to do that way too often. You spelled two wrong, buddy. I never spelled two wrong. Never leave your phone alone around your goofy friends. And I'm not deleting this. You should definitely go through this comment thread here. It's actually pretty funny.
Speaking of James, I lost him. I had to go down to the front desk and get a new card because when I went to go get a brand new battery for my camera, I ended up leaving my key card inside the room and locked myself out. So, yeah. On a positive note, remember how earlier there was a whole party going on in here? Now it's empty and it's quiet.
Whoa. Cool.
Probably some people cleaning.
Oh, check it out. It's a mermaid. Cool. Oh, it's another mermaid over there.
I love mermaids so much that I got one tattooed on my arm. Now I get to go back into the elevator. Gotta go up. But you have to have a key card to make the elevator work. This one. Okay, cool. I wanna show you how many freaking floors there are. You can see right here, they skipped 13 and went right to 14. So where's the 13th floor? Or is this really the 13th floor? And instead of 29 floors, there's really 28 floors. Well, let's check out the 29th floor. Oh, come on, you're not gonna work now? What about if I wanna go to my floor? Okay, now it worked. There we go, that was weird. I'll tell you what, this elevator is fast. You were going through floors so quick. My ears are popping. Mirrors. A lot more mirrors.
Dude, it's so pretty.
Wow. That's where the Cincinnati Bengals play. Pretty cool. Cincinnati's really pretty.
There's a lot more mirrors here than on my floor. Thank you.
was certain that people were gonna come out of that elevator, and I even had my camera down because I didn't want to disturb anybody. This looks exactly like my floor. I'm on the sixth floor. It's funny because a little bit earlier I ran into a maintenance worker inside of one of the elevators, and he gets off at the wrong floor. He's like, oh, no, this is the wrong floor. He's like, all these floors look exactly alike. So yeah, I have to agree with him. We're on the very top floor. It's a massive building. I want to say there's like 561 guest rooms. Yeah, like I said, Elvis loved coming here, and he stayed in the room that we're in right now. This thing really shakes. Whew. Ears popping again. So we just went from the 29th to the 28th floor with, you know, the missing 13th floor. I never noticed we have mirrors here too. And they're facing each other like portals. I forgot. There's people sleeping. It's all love. Anytime you come to a haunted location, especially hotels, always ask the workers, especially with hauntings and things like that, because there's a lot that they know that is not available online. Now, one thing I found out, supposedly there was a room 666 on this floor. This says that it goes from room 634 to 658. So if room 666 existed, if that is true, it more than likely would have been on this side. And that's where we're staying. Another really freaky thing is, check this out. 666. And then over here, 666. Okay, you ever seen the movie The Shining? Total Shining vibes here. Somebody coming. A lot of noises in these old buildings. Hopefully this works. Oh, there we go. You'll have to excuse my messy friend. Jamesy boy.
Yeah, sure.
Hey, you're in here. That's James's mess.
Yeah.
Messy side over there. And then
look at over there. You got a ton of mess over there.
Well, that's my computer and stuff. I haven't even organized it yet. Here's the card that I left. And you have a card, don't you?
Yes.
Because you got in here. I had to get a card from the front desk. Did you see anything cool?
Yeah, bro.
You know there's nobody downstairs anymore. Like, yeah. it's completely quiet now.
Yeah, it's awesome.
Yeah. So, did you go on any other floors?
Bro, I found something out that I think you should definitely check out.
Okay.
So, I found out a story. Back in 1953, she left a mental sanatorium. They said that she was fine. 3 weeks later, she came to Cincinnati, tried to throw herself in front of a bus. Luckily, the bus driver was able to stop and, you know, she was fine. She came into the hotel afterwards, this particular hotel. She went into the staircase, not the elevator, the staircase, walked all the way up to the 28th floor. She threw herself off the building to her death.
Wait, when did that happen?
1953.
Damn.
And the hell was that?
Bro, I think we have some nosy neighbors up there.
I haven't heard any noises the whole time we've been here for 2 days.
I didn't say nosy, I was trying to say noisy. I think nosy came out. Maybe they're being nosy too.
Or maybe that was... Because what I was about to say was, the employees here ever since have heard noises coming in the staircase from the 28th to the 29th floor. Well, I went up there, bro.
Uh-huh.
And
I was just on the 29th floor.
Did you go in the staircase?
No, I was in the elevator.
You need to go to the staircase, because as I'm in the staircase, all of a sudden I started hearing voices talking like in the 29th floor, because I walked up to the 20th, and I'm like, okay, that's just people talking in the hallway.
Uh-huh.
Well, all of a sudden I start hearing, it sounds like somebody's walking up the steps. There's nobody there. And I'm like, holy crap, that's crazy. I look at it and I go right for the door where the 29th floor is, where I heard the people talking.
Uh-huh.
There's nobody there. Nobody there.
What the hell?
Freaking just strange, bro.
Well, you know what?
There aren't very many people right now wandering the hotel, but there... Oh, you know what? I ran into a fam.
Nuh-uh.
Yeah, I was like... Well, I went to go get in an elevator, but I wanted to film inside the elevator, so I didn't want to bother the people. And when the elevator opened, this one guy comes out to, because I was on his floor. He was like, "You're Omar, aren't you?" And we took like a picture together and stuff.
Oh, that's cool,
but
bro.
I mean, there was a lot of people coming to their rooms right now. Well, while I was on the 29th floor, I thought that was going to happen again because people were partying downstairs. Mm-hmm. I hear the elevator ding, the doors open, I put my camera down. I'm like, okay, I'm just gonna have to take a break. Happens a lot, because, you know, you don't wanna...
Same thing I did earlier, right?
Same thing. Put my camera down, nobody's in the freaking elevator, nobody. It opened up, it's almost like it got summoned.
That's weird, bro.
Yeah, elevator opens up, nobody there. Yeah. I wonder if some of these elevators, though, like, just go to random floors.
Bro, I didn't even tell you.
What?
Remember that hallway of shadows, or what do they call it? The hallway of mirrors. What is it called?
The hall of mirrors. Yeah.
I was in there. I'm literally filming into the mirror, and I didn't realize what was behind me, but all of a sudden I hear, ting. And I turn around, I start walking. I was like, what the hell is that? Freaking piano in the middle of the room. It sounded like a damn somebody pressed the piano key. And I'm literally filming in the mirror. And you can see the piano behind me, which I didn't realize was a piano. You could tell there was nobody there.
No, I saw a piano in there. There's like a baby grand piano in there.
Bro, you literally hear the piano as I'm filming in the mirror, and you could see the piano. There's nobody to touch the piano. There's nobody in
there.
Wait,
what if it feels like a mouse or something?
Well, they say that's where the lady in green hangs out.
Right. Well, I did hear some noises in there, like some little, but I mean, I didn't hear no piano. That's actually pretty cool.
It was way cool.
That's probably one of the more active floors, but yeah, we're going to do something a little bit different. I have to kind of talk James into it, though. We're going to go live here. Make sure that you go and subscribe to my Omar Gosh live channel. I do a lot of live streams on that channel, like I was mentioning to you, and I leave them up. They're amazing. Some great videos there. I have some like behind the scenes explorers there too. So yeah, check it out. I'm gonna go live right now, by the way. Wanna join in?
Do I have a choice?
No.
Good morning, James.
Good morning, bro.
Did you have a good sleep?
I mean, the 3.5 hours, yeah.
Yeah.
I think we've been sleeping 3 or 4 hours every night. That's about it.
That's true, man. James especially had a good sleep, though, because when I woke up a little bit earlier than him, I came back and, you know, there's some toilet paper on the floor, some lotion bottles here, and you thought I wasn't going to see it, bro. Like,
all you have to do is go to IG and you'll see exactly what he did.
We had a really good time here at the Netherland Plaza. Also known as the Hilton Netherland Plaza. Amazing place, amazing staff. There's so much that we didn't even get to see. We have to come back here again. It's amazing. If you love history, if you love old buildings that have been preserved throughout the years, this is one of those places that I think in the 1990s, no, in the 1980s, they went through an overhaul of remodeling, and that remodeling itself was millions and millions of dollars. We did do a live stream last night. In fact, we did two. If you were on my live stream, and I mean, I don't know when I was able to upload the video that you're watching right now, but you know, when live streams are available, they are available and they're live. When it comes to videos like this, they do take a little bit of time to go through, sometimes weeks, sometimes months. And that's why I love them so much, because we put a lot of time into them and they're cool. But anyways, James and I are gonna get out of here and move on to our next adventure. Be sure to subscribe to James if you haven't already. Really important to follow us on social media too, because we be doing some goofy stuff.
Yeah, we do.
So like I shared with you last night, like on those Twitter posts and stuff like that. Gotta go for now before we leave. Give me a kiss. Peace.